Listen to me. Tell me everything you know about this mechanic, or me and James will take care of you. Tell me your secrets! Granny? I think Granny is on the verge of becoming a little bit too delusional to be in this house alone. First, there was the butcher, or the signs of a potential butcher incoming. And then, there was the dog. I don't like dogs, because I'm a cat. And now, for some odd reason, Granny has had the brilliant idea of hiring a mechanic. He looks like this. Oh, he's really scary. He looks like he could be friends with the butcher, and I don't appreciate that. I don't like the fact that you have so many friends and only one cat. You see, I am not able to defend myself against three full-grown humans, let alone, you know, three humans and a dog. So I'm just gonna try and see if there is any merit to this little whole mechanic thing, right? Because there is the garage over here, and I'm thinking, right? If Granny's gonna get a garage, she might need a mechanic to take care of her car. I haven't seen her drive a car yet, though. That's a little bit suspicious, if you ask me. But like, yeah, this place definitely needs some sort of a mechanic. All right, that's enough, all right? That's enough, I've just had it. I am gonna uncover the truth. And I'm also gonna ask myself why Granny always looks at the black TV with nothing on it. There's nothing, listen Granny, I've got your back, okay? You wanna watch something? I can give you something. Here you go, here's your, whoops, oh God. Oh, did I break it? I didn't break it. All right, cool. All right, just get this over here and just put the PC monitor right up.
Monitors on me. Help.
Okay, I might actually need your help, though. The monitor is literally stuck here. I can't get it off. Come on, then. Just get... Okay, you know what? No. No, not gonna touch it. The monitor's broken, and I'm really sorry about it. Or am I? No, Granny, I need you to tell me all the secrets you have hiding around this whole place. Otherwise, I am going to drown the lovely fish of yours that you've neglected on top of the little ventilation thing over there. Okay, I'm going to drown him. I promise you. I'm a cat. I'm a fierce cat with golden claws. I'm not afraid to use them for evil. Tell me where it is. Tell me what's happening. And are we going to get a mechanic or not? Tell me. Tell me. I promise you, this will be the end of him. What is it that you're watching? Why is it a black screen? Shouldn't it be subscribe to Wacky? Because that makes sense, you know? It makes sense if there's something on the screen. Anyway, I'm gonna go upstairs because I haven't really been a lot upstairs. And if there's any mechanic incoming over here, there's bound to be some secrets somewhere, right? Why don't we start with going up there? And maybe there's like some notes of like a mechanic coming this place. There's the USB stick. Maybe this has more hidden features in it than, you know, I'm thinking of. So I'm just gonna put this down over. Why does it say cat on the floor? That wasn't there when I got here. Is that the work of the mechanic? Oh no. Is he a sneaky mechanic? Oh God, bunch of cubes. I don't like that. I don't like the fact that there's things appearing on the floor when I'm in the middle of uncovering secrets. Do we have any secrets in the books here? Anything at all? Or is this just nonsense? I doubt Granny's even read them. You know what I thought about though? The red car, okay? This thing, mm-hmm. Why would Granny have a toy red car in one of the shelves here unless she had an affair? Oh no. Oh, is the mechanic Granny's secret lover? Oh no, surely not. I'm gonna go ask Granny right now. Granny? Granny, look at this red car, okay? I've uncovered your secrets. Tell me what's between you and the mechanic, huh? Is this something that I should know? I'm gonna let you look at the car for a little bit and then you can tell me, okay? And if you don't tell me, I'm just gonna start breaking things in your home until you actually tell me.
6.5 hours later.
Some time has passed and Granny is yet to tell me what the mechanic and the car has in common. So I'm just gonna start wrecking the house. How about them apples, huh? She's been there looking at the TV screen for so long, she doesn't even know what time it is anymore, and she's forgotten to feed me on top of everything, you know? I'm here trying to save my skin, and you just sit looking at a completely empty screen, don't even feed me, you don't even care about me anymore, do you, Granny? You see, she's just waving her fist at me. There you go, have a plate! Oh, God. Sorry. I mean, it's kind of funny, though. It's a little hilarious. What are you gonna do, huh? Are you gonna wave your fist again? There you go. I've also got a fist.
Scratch it. Oh.
Is this the mechanics room? Or is that the mechanics room? Or is that the mechanics room? Why are there so many doors here? And why are these doors never open, Granny? I'm gonna force her to open them, if that's the last thing I do. So when she turns around, I'm gonna pounce at her, and we're gonna force her to open the doors. I'm gonna force you to open the doors. Here we go, and boom! Come on then, Granny. I need your help. I need you to open these doors so I can check what's inside. And if you don't help, oh God, there's the frying pan again. If you don't help me, I will figure it out on my own. I promise you. Please don't chase me down too much. Please don't, please. Granny, we can talk about this. We can talk about this. I'm not the one doing naughty things. It's you. It's you and that filthy mechanic. Now, while Granny's over there watching the TV, I'm gonna play a prank on her. I'm turning the TV on from way over here, and there's nothing she can do about it. Look at this. I'm gonna switch the channels. Oh, is that right? You got bored? Well, I was just getting started. What are you gonna do without a remote, though, huh? What are you gonna do if I just break the remote? Tell me who it is. And is he gonna come anytime soon to this house? Is he gonna help you move? What does he and the butcher and the dog have in common? They're strangers! Ah! And his foot is about to get a whole lot worse. Oh, here we go. And the other foot. That's right. I've made you unable to walk. You should not be able to walk anymore whatsoever. Wait, what? How is she standing up? She's looking outdoors again. Is she looking at the cars? Is one of the cars the mechanic cars? There's one way to find out. And that is to go on top of the roof to find out if the cars are the mechanics or if there's just, you know, something other there, like neighbors and stuff. So here we go, on top of the roof. Been here many times. All right. Is any of these cars the mechanic's car? I mean, that's a blue one. I'm thinking one of these ones could be the butcher's car. There's also a car behind there parked far away in the neighborhood. That could be the butcher's car. He's trying to hide and whatnot. So as far as I can tell, there's Granny. Oh, I could actually sneak attack her from right over here, and there's nothing she can do about it. I think I'm gonna do that. Granny, tell me the secret! Okay, so Granny, I didn't actually see any cars outside that would indicate that there's a mechanic coming. So is it true? Is it just a false news thing that I've gotten? Is it, or is that actually happening? If you wave at me, I know it's true. Oh no. She seems happier than normal. Oh no, she's gonna watch the TV. Ah, not on my watch! Not on my watch, she's not. All right, here we go. Any second now, when Granny turns on the TV, I'm gonna turn it off. I'm gonna get on her nerves so bad. She's gonna think there's something wrong with her TV, okay? And when she thinks there's something wrong, she's gonna call somebody to help. And I'm thinking, you know, the mechanic, you know, is good with electricity and cars and stuff. Maybe he's good with TVs. So in case she calls for help, I bet she's gonna call him. And that way, I can slit his throat with my golden claws. There you go, that's right, Granny, your TV's broken. Look at that. Even when it's on, it's switching channels all the time. That's not cool. There you go, exactly. Now call the mechanic, because I'm here to take him on like a cat. Like a mad cat. But first, pre-fight snack. These are delicious, Granny, thank you. Does Granny even have a phone? It just occurred to me. Does Granny even own a phone? Huh? Surely she has a phone, right? You can't be an elderly lady living alone in a house without a phone. But now that I think about it, I've never actually seen a phone. That is bizarre. No? I can't remember the code. Of course, I just remembered it from off my head. Ooh, there we go. Okay. Friends. That has to be it, right? Friends. All right. I'm going to see if there's any clues in these pictures of a mechanic. Maybe one of these cats is the mechanic's cat. All right, let's just have a cheeky little look. Yeah, there's nothing here indicating a mechanic, a cardboard box. Could it be car parts? They come in cardboard boxes, right? Could it be, is this the mechanic's cat? You waved at me! I saw it! Toilet! Why would a cat be in a toilet, afraid for its life? Look, that is the face of a cat that's that's brain rot, you should not watch that. That's the last picture, but that gives me the biggest hope. I think that is a cat that's afraid for its life and that there might be a mechanic coming this way soon. So she's constantly standing over here looking at the same view. She's looking at this view every single day. Has the granny and the mechanic been in that little swing there, having a wonderful time of their life? Oh, here she comes again. Look, and she's probably gonna stand right here, look at this exact view, waiting for something to happen. Is that right, granny? No, actually, I don't think about it. Probably as good as it'll ever be. Cat pounce! Sorry, granny. I'm not sorry. I meant to do it. Oh, her glasses are really dirty. There we go. Much better. Oh, yeah. Now you can see me. Maybe that's been the problem all along. Maybe she hasn't been able to see me. There you go. Ah, I'm your favorite cat. I am the cat that you adore. Give me food. I don't think I'm going to get any answers out of granny anytime soon. It seems like she's on a mission to keep this a secret forever. Well, not on my watch. Hello there, James. Right. Huh? Have you heard about the mechanic? Because I haven't. This is the first time I've learned about him. And Granny's keeping it a secret. I need you to team up with me to take Granny down and force her to give her our answers that we want to hear. And not just any answer, but like answers that we want to hear. Are you ready to take over the world? Or take over Granny's house? You know, whichever one you like. All right, we need to get you into camouflage. So I'm just gonna put you here, okay? And then I know exactly how we're gonna camouflage you. We're gonna take this, we're gonna put it on top of you, and we're gonna glue some knives on top of it. You just take this, here you go, in you go. It's a snug fit, but it'll do. There you go. Aha! Granny will never suspect a thing. There you go, perfect. And then we just need a knife. Or two. You know, one knife will pierce deeper. Unless, you know, if there's two knives right next to each other, it's not gonna pierce as deep. Hello, James? Are you fine? Yeah, you're good. You're good. Okay, look how well the knife is on there, huh? All right, follow me. We're about to take on Granny once and for all to get some answers. Granny, stop listening to that nonsense and listen to me. Tell me everything you know about this mechanic or me and James will take care of you. I will use my deadly claws that I've been given at some point, and I'm gonna use them against you, okay? I know I've got fuzzy paws, but in between them are deadly claws. All right, then. Well, if that's how you wanna play it, I can play a game. That's right, that's right. James, what are you doing? Get over here, stop messing about. Bring that knife to me, and we can dissect Granny. Right, come on then. Well, if James doesn't come to me, I'll just take Granny to James. That's what I'm gonna do. Okay, just get it. Okay, Granny's a little bit on the heavy side. Yeah, she should eat less cakes and work out a little bit more. Come on then. Oh, there you are. Hi. Oh no. No. We can talk about this. James, I need assistance right now. James, slicing Granny. No, she kicked James over. What a ruthless old lady here she is. All right. Hot power! It didn't work. You silly goose. Stop, get out of here, will you? Come on. Oh man, you're really stuck in there, aren't you? There we go. Welcome back. Okay, are you able to move without this thing on you? What if I just put it like this? Is that better? I just realized James is the perfect robot to transport water. He's so stable. Anyway, that's not why I'm here. I'm here to throw this. That Granny, because she's not telling me anything. She's just mute! It didn't work! Nah! Wait, what? What is happening? Is Granny immortal? Surely not. Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm not sorry. That was what I meant to do. Tell me your secrets! Granny? Oh no, she's... Granny, that's what happens when you don't tell me about the potential mechanic coming to this house. You're actually... Oh God, oh, I'm so sorry. Oh, James, bring me the knife. Knife, come on. Fine then, I'll use my claws. How about them? How do you like that, Granny? Well, this is actually, that's right. Broke the pot over her. Did she just teleport in front of me? Granny, die! Uh-oh, okay, come on then. Come on, you wanna fight? I'm game. That's right, I've gotten superpowers. I'm so strong. I'm one of the strongest cats you will ever meet, and there's nothing you can do about it. Nothing! So tell me about the mechanic. Tell me right now. So James, I need you to look away, okay? Because things are gonna get a little nasty. Just look away, there you go. Just look at that. Because I just found the sharpest weapon in the game. It's stuck in Granny. Run away, James, run away. I've done a horrible thing. Now, if you like this video, you might like the one up here. Thanks.